Hi, my name is Henry Su. I'm part of the Poker Chip Dispenser group for ME106 Fundamentals of Mechatronics class. For this project, I contributed by designing the physical part of it, buying a lot of the materials to make it, and then I oversaw the construction of it. On top of that, I helped out. I helped out with the coding.
What are you gonna learn?
Oh yeah, and then So this is the first time that I actually integrated software with hardware. So I learned a lot about some of the restrictions that software has that is imposed on hardware, and a lot of hardware restrictions that are imposed on software. Such as like my initial design of the project, I didn't take into account location of the Arduino, the number of motor drivers we were going to use, and how we were going to position it all to fit properly. And by the end of the project, I kind of had to alter the design to fit it all together.
Hi, my name is James Jimenez-Gordon. I primarily did the coding for this project, as well as I helped out a little bit with the design of the project, implementing all of the wiring, implementing the motors into it. Originally, our design incorporated 3 stepper motors and a ultrasonic sensor. Unfortunately, we couldn't get that to work, so we had to scrap one of the stepper motors, and then we swapped out another one with a solenoid. So our final design ended up having a solenoid, a stepper motor, and then the ultrasonic sensor. So again, I primarily did the coding. I had to code the ultrasonic sensor, the stepper motor, the solenoid, all of that to work together. Unfortunately, we never got the solenoid to work properly. We believe that was primarily attributed to the fact that we weren't getting enough current to flow through the solenoid. We definitely, if we had more time, we could have looked into amplifying that and getting that to work properly. Phil did the calculations for the stepper motor, so I went ahead and coded that to rotate the base. We bought the stepper motor from XS Solutions, so we weren't quite sure if it was going to work, but we ended up getting it to work at a low RPM. I believe our value was 15 RPM. The wiring was a bit of a mess at first. Our original wiring schematic was all over the place. We took up way too many pins, so we edited that, we cut that down, got it looking a lot neater, that helped out. I helped with the design as far as figuring out where the Arduino needed to be placed, where the stepper motor needed to be positioned, how the solenoid and the ultrasonic were going to be configured in the design and all like that. As far as things I've learned how to code the ultrasonic sensor, as well as how to code the solenoid and the stepper motor. We had a bit of practice with the stepper motor before, so that wasn't too difficult once we actually got it working properly. Coding the solenoid was a bit tricky, but I believe the way we did it is okay. Unfortunately, I'm not really sure since we never got the solenoid to work. Coding the ultrasonic sensor was interesting. I learned from Eric that apparently there's a dead zone that you shouldn't operate within, so that probably would have been handy to know before doing the entire coding, but knowing that now, I know how to fine-tune the design later on. Other things that we could have did differently, we probably could have gotten all of our materials a bit sooner so that we could have gotten an earlier start. That most likely would have helped us identify our issues early on and fix them earlier on.
My name is Philip Lagba. I was responsible for the calculations for the motor, and I also contributed to building the poker chip dispenser and coding for the poker chip dispenser to work. I learned how to I learned how to do the calculations for the motor. I never had to do that when I was working with software. Since I'm the electrical engineer in the group, I wasn't sure how this would work whenever you're integrating it with the mechanical design of the motor. One thing that I could have done a little more was study how or what kind of motor could have been used for our design. We weren't thorough with how much torque we needed, the specific motor that we could have used to make this work, and yeah, I think that's it.